This is your WITN Morning News Update on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Good morning. Two teenagers are behind bars charged in a series of delivery driver robberies. Greenville police arrested 18-year-old Annie Holiday and 16-year-old Jabari May on Thursday afternoon. Between December 23rd and December 27th, police responded to two armed robberies of restaurant delivery drivers and one attempted armed robbery of a pizza delivery driver. In two of the cases, the drivers attempted to deliver food when the suspect or suspects appeared from the side of the house and robbed them at gunpoint. In one case, a Domino's delivery driver pulled up to the house and noticed two men hiding in the bushes. Police say he did not get out of the car and immediately drove off. May is accused of the armed robberies of delivery drivers from China King and Jet's Pizza, as well as an attempted robbery of a Domino's driver. He is charged with two counts of robbery and dangerous weapon and three counts of conspiracy to commit robbery with a dangerous weapon. Holiday is accused in the attempted robbery of the Domino's delivery driver, as well as the armed robbery of the Jet's Pizza driver. She is charged with one count of robbery with a dangerous weapon and two counts of conspiracy. Thousands of people have lost power on another frigid night. Some of them are the very same people who lost power Thursday morning. Early this morning, Thailand EMC reported more than 8,900 customers without power. Beaufort County had 5,900 in the dark and cold, while there were 2,800 customers in Hyde County without power. About 150 customers in Washington County lost power as well. There are eight outages affecting these thousands of people. We're also seeing 380 people without power in Pitt County, served by Edgecombe Martin EMC. Another 150 of their customers in Beaufort County have lost power, as have 90 in Edgecombe County. Energy companies have asked people to conserve power where possible during the cold temperatures because of the massive pull on the power grids. Duke Energy has suggested lowering thermostats, unplugging unused chargers, and saving chores which require energy for later. All of that would decrease the demand on energy systems across the state. Freezing rain and power outage has prompted school delays in the east today. Duplin County Schools said freezing rain in the area has prompted a two-hour delay for the students and staff. And the Madam Mesquite campus in Hyde County also announced a two-hour delay for today. That delay was credited to a power outage. Stay tuned to WITN News and keep an eye on WITN.com for the latest on any weather-related closings and delays. State health officials reported 30 people died of complications from the flu in North Carolina just last week, more than double the number from the previous week and raising the death toll for the season to 54. The North Carolina Department of Health and Human Services reports all of the deaths for the latest reporting period involve people 65 years of age and older. Of the 54 deaths, 42 have involved people in that age range. Last week, the state reported 14 flu-related deaths. There have been only two deaths involving people between the ages of 5 and 17, the latest one occurring in the week ending November 15, 2014. Earlier this week, health officials said that the flu season appeared to be peaking about a month earlier than normal. And last and the latest that we have is that the Paris Charles de Gaulle Airport has closed two runways and two arrivals amid a massive operation to seize two suspects in the storing of a satirical newspaper. An airport spokesman said the flight diversions are not affecting schedules, and at least three helicopters have been hovering above the town of Dammartin-en-Goulet near the airport. A French police official said the pair of brothers suspected in the attack in which 12 people died appear to have taken a hostage. And that's your latest from WITN News.
Mostly clear skies for your Friday with a low around 20 degrees. Plenty of sunshine today. Clear skies for tonight with lows dipping down to around 18. For your Saturday, sunny with a high near 36. Clear for tomorrow night with lows around 21 degrees. And for your Sunday, mostly sunny skies with a high near 48. Lows around 21. It is 28 degrees right now in Greenville, 29 in New Bern. Talk of the town. Friday, the 9th day of January, 2015. Hour number two of TOT coming up. State Representative Paul Tyne and U.S. Senator Tom Tillis coming up after 8:30. Stay tuned. All that more on this Friday Talk of the Town.
It's the big finish of 2014 here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 starting at $19,990 and payments as low as $249 a month here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
You ask a friend to recommend a doctor when you're sick. Why not rely on a friend to recommend a personal injury attorney when you've been seriously injured?
At Hardy & Hardy, we treat our clients like family, which is why they often recommend us to their family and friends.
If you or a loved one has been involved in an accident and are searching for an attorney, visit HardyandHardy.com to see what our clients have to say about us.
Hardy and Hardy, protecting the rights of the seriously injured.
Uptown Greenville is the voice of the downtown. We exist to promote quality, cultural, residential, and economic development.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
It's alive.
Safe.
It's awesome. It's a great place to work.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
Student at East Carolina University.
Co-founder of eAudit.com.
A sergeant with the Center City Unit.
Owner of the Varsity Club.
Our downtown has a name, and it's Uptown.
I'm good like that.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Hey, it's Riverboat Ron on a Pepsi can.
You need a cool nickname like Riverboat Ron.
I do?
Yeah.
The Lugner Eclipse.
Yeah. Fine 59.
Oh. Kinkly Cat. You know, like kitty cat. Those are terrible.
The new Pepsi 18-pack featuring limited edition Carolina Panthers collector cans. Grab one for game day. Pepsi, official soft drink of the Panthers and all for the Carolinas.
The Luke Ness Monster.
No. Bummer.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MYVIDANT to learn how you can sign up.
It's the big finish of 2014 here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 starting at $19,990 and payments as low as $249 a month here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Hey, wait a minute. That doesn't sound right. This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton. News, laughs, community information, and all the knowledge you need to be the smartest one in the room. Unless you are in the same room as Henry, of course.
Oh, sad nap.
This is Talk of the Town on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
13 after 8, welcome back. It's hour 2 of Talk of the Town. It is Friday, everybody. It's a TGIF edition of Talk of the Town. It's great to have you here. Nice to be here this morning. We have had some reports of black ice on the road. And so if you are traveling, there was a truck overturned in Beaufort County on Highway 17, we were told. Please, please, please be careful. And that includes you, Representative Paul Tyne, who is driving right now, probably listening to us, wondering when we're going to call him, which is any moment now. He's driving from Kitty Hawk to Raleigh this morning to find out the fate of his political future with regard to the Republican caucus. Paul Tyne represents... District 6 in the North Carolina House of Representatives, Beaufort County, Hyde County, Washington County, and Dare County. Insurance sales guy up in insurance agency owner up in Kitty Hawk. And he announced on Wednesday that he is leaving the Democratic Party. And the Republican caucus in the House of Representatives is going to vote this morning to either accept Paul Tyne or say, no, you're a man without a country. And so we'll see what happens. And we're going to talk to Paul Tyne in just a minute. Why would a longtime Democrat in the North Carolina General Assembly leave the Democratic Party? I have my reasons why I would if I were him, but I want to hear it from him. And right after that, Senator Tom Tillis, his first radio interview in the state of North Carolina since he's become a United States Senator. Tom Tillis will be with us in 15 minutes, so set your clocks with that, and let's get going. And let me welcome in Mark Gentner from WITN this morning. Good morning, Marky Mark. How are
good
you?
Good morning, Henry.
Thank
how are you?
Thank you for hanging around. It's nice to see you.
You bet.
Appreciate the news updates
here.
This morning from WITN and McGee on Sports coming up. How are you, Trent?
I'm doing fine.
Nice to do. Lots of high school basketball tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, big night for it.
And I guess Carolina Panthers –
tomorrow. We'll have it for you here, 7 o'clock. Airtime for the pregame show here on the Panthers Radio Network. Eastern North Carolina's home for the Panthers here on 103.7.
Yep.
And then Panthers in Seattle tomorrow night. What, do you give them any chance?
You know, Seattle's actually a 10.5-point favorite in that game.
You know what? That's about – Panthers play Seattle tough.
Yeah.
And they play them tough.
That's a ridiculous point spread, by the way. I mean –
But, you know, they beat them 12-9 earlier this year, yeah. So – And then last year it was like 13-6 or something.
I mean, yeah, you know,
it's going to be a one touchdown or
play. It's a tough place to play.
Tough home team.
Cam Newton's got to be really, really good.
Yep.
And then WITN has the other NFL game tomorrow. Yeah,
we got the Patriots Ravens. That should be a good game.
What's that? 4:15?
Yeah,
4 o'clock.
4 something. 4:35. I think it's kickoff.
The pregame will start in 10 minutes from now.
Yeah,
they'll have a long pregame tomorrow. So a lot of NFL football over the weekend. All right, 15 after 8 o'clock. We mentioned Tom Tillis will be on with us here in about 15 minutes. But let's talk state politics for a second. The biggest news in the state this week in state politics is the fact that a longtime Democrat is leaving the Democratic Party and would like to caucus with the Republican House of Representatives. Now, if you don't understand how that works... You know, the Republican House members have what is called a caucus, where they basically get together and have their own meetings before and decide on, you know, what their philosophies and strategy. They try to get together as a team when they go down to the floor of the House and try to get their legislation passed. And of course, caucuses don't always stay together either. The House caucus. Last year, I think Tom Tillis, being the strong leader that he was, he kept that House caucus together. But there are a lot of different factions in the Republican Party now, as you know. And so, but that's the purpose of the caucus. They meet and then they decide on, you know, what where they're going to go with what their agenda is. And the Democrats do the same thing. Well, Paul Todd's been a member of the Democratic caucus because he was elected as a Democratic House of Representatives member. And now he's leaving the Democratic Party saying, I'm not going to become a Republican, but I would like to caucus with the Republicans. Why would you do that? Let's go to the phone and find out from the man himself, State House Representative Paul Tyne of District 6 on the telephone with us. By the way, District 6 is parts of Beaufort, Hyde, Washington, and Dare County. And Representative Tyne joins us on the telephone right now, probably driving to Raleigh, right? Paul, good morning to you.
Good morning to you, and yeah, I'm on my way to Raleigh right now. I just pulled off to the side, and I appreciate you having me this morning.
All right, well, thank you very much. And you will find out today, am I right? They're going to vote this morning on whether or not that you will become a member of the Republican caucus, not the Republican Party, but you are going to be either voted in or out as a member of the caucus this morning for the Republicans. Is that the way it's going to work?
Yeah, that's my understanding.
So do you feel like you're kind of awaiting the news? I mean, are you confident about this? I mean, where do you stand on this?
Well, you know, I had some discussions in December with the Republican leadership, and they were very welcoming and on board. But, you know, they're a small portion of their overall caucus, and the individual members have the right and should have the right under their bylaws to decide, you know, who comes in and who doesn't.
What I hear you saying is that Tim Moore, for instance, who has been voted by the caucus to be the Speaker of the House, he has to be ratified by the full House on Wednesday. But Tim Moore, for instance, has said to you, come on over, we'll accept you in.
Yeah, the leadership has, including Tim Moore, and there's been some quotes out there in the press by Speaker-elect Moore that, you know, they're looking forward to working with me.
All right. Now, Paul, you know, obviously this is going to be somewhat controversial that you just were reelected as a Democrat, and now 60 days later you're saying you're not going to be a Democrat anymore. What kind of response have you gotten? And, well, let's start with this question first. Why are you doing it? Why are you leaving the Democratic Party?
Well, and there's two main reasons. The first one is the district that I represent. We have a lot of issues out here in the East, from transportation funding. We've got high poverty rates. We're still behind in job creation. So, you know, as an independent working with the majority, I feel that I'm going to be able to get more done for the district. So that's first and primary. The second reason is, you know, I'm a fiscal conservative. I believe that, you know, the government should stay out of our personal lives as much as possible. And that's who I've been, how I've voted, and the message that I've carried over the last 3 years. And there's been a series of decisions made in November that really showed me that I wasn't going to have that space to operate inside of the Democratic Party. So, you know, this fits me as an independent.
Do you mean that maybe you were up for leadership in the Democratic Party and didn't get it? Is that what you're saying?
No, I didn't run for leadership. I did support someone else running for leadership that had vowed to make room for those of us that are, you know, in the center, that are more moderate. And then after that, there were several other procedural things and organizational things where, you know, I had asked to make sure that there was room for those of us that are in the middle. And, you know, when they came out with the new leadership slate that we didn't have an opportunity to vote on, it really didn't represent those moderate members that are in the caucus. And there are other moderate members in that caucus, there's no doubt about it. And I respect them for staying there and still trying to work to bring the Democratic Party back to the center. I just didn't feel that my energy should be spent fighting my own party while I've got a district that has so many needs.
You know, what you're saying is something I've been talking about for a couple of years, which is the continued slide to the left of the Democratic Party. We didn't have that in North Carolina. Your friend and mine, Mark Basnight, when he was, of course, right there in Dare County with you, when he was the Senate President pro tem, the state of North Carolina's Democratic Party did not act the way it acts today. I mean, I think what we have now is a Democratic Party that has slid further and further and further to the left as other parts of the country, particularly New York, California, Florida, when the Democratic Party is just going so far left at this point, it seems like, you know, this is a kind of a watershed moment for the North Carolina Democrats when they lose a guy like you, because what we hear you saying is they've gone too far left. I mean, that's kind of what's happening in the state, is it not?
Yeah, I would love to see either party get back to the middle. And we had a tradition in North Carolina of the Democrats being in the center and being pro-business and being balanced. And, you know, if you look at the policies that have been put forth in North Carolina and at the federal level, they're really not representative of you know, my personal feelings, but also the feelings of my district.
All right. So now you leave the Democratic Party. What kind of response are you having from your constituents? Are you hearing from some folks who are angry that you ran as a Democrat and 60 days later you're switching out of the party?
Oh yeah, sure. And I completely understand their frustration. I have always presented myself, though, as an independent thinking centrist. I've voted across the lines. But I tell you, overwhelmingly, it's been, you know, 4-1 or so in emails and phone calls that have been more positive than negative, so, which actually surprised me. I thought that I'd actually have more pushback. But when you're a representative, you know, when I was a Democrat, I got pushback because I was a Democrat. And when I voted against Democrats, I got pushback because I voted against Democrats. If you can get, you know, if you're making a decision with this much positive response, I wish I could do it all the time.
To get elected to anything in this day and age, you have to raise money. And I'm assuming there have been a lot of people who gave you money that probably, you know, were huge Democrats that may be looking at this and going, hey, you took my money and used it to get elected, and now you're leaving the Democratic Party. Have you had some of that?
You know, not so much on the money side. One or two comments here or there. You know, mainly if you look at who has donated to me, I've had independents, Republicans, and conservative Democrats. Quite frankly, a lot of the folks that contributed, you know, some of my friends that have thrown fundraisers for me. I had Republicans, I had independents, and the Democrats, I've had more than a few of them say, okay, good, let's go ahead and go be independent.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dare County, where you live, of course, is a very conservative county, but it's also always been a pretty Democrat county with a stronghold of Democratic activity up there. My buddy RV Owens has always been a big player up there, his father Bobby and of course Mark Bassnight. There was no more powerful politician ever in the state of North Carolina than Senator Bassnight. By the way, how is he? Is he doing okay?
I actually saw his old chief of staff the other day in Raleigh and inquired with her because she talks to him quite a bit. And, you know, it sounds like he's doing well right now.
Good. Well, we hope so. We know he's had some health challenges. All right. Well, we'll see what happens today, Paul. And I mentioned this to you yesterday. We're going to be up there doing doing this show live at the legislature at the Daily Planet Cafe on Wednesday morning. I'll get back to you, but we'd love to have you come over and talk to us, and we'll talk more about your agenda and what you want to get done for District 6 as we move into probably as the newest member of the Republican, and unprecedented, by the way, you'll be the only independent in the General Assembly. So, where's your office?
Yeah, well, and
where's your office going to be? I mean, who's going to have lunch with you? People, I mean, what's going to happen?
it's definitely, this has been a big leap. I'd hate to stand up at the beginning of each session and announce my caucus of one to meet the next day. But I still think this is just the right decision. I've been independent-minded. My district is independent-minded. We've always been independent out here in the East, and I'm excited about the change.
All right. Well, we'll see you Wednesday, and we'll obviously be very interested in how this vote turns out today. They've invited you to come up today, so, hopefully they're not calling you up there to tell you no, but we'll see how it goes when the Republicans vote this morning.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much again for talking with me and letting people know. And my cell phone's all over the place online. If people need to call out and reach out to me and let me know their feelings, I'm happy to hear from them.
All right, Paul. Thank you very much, Representative Paul Tyne. We'll see you when we're up there on Wednesday. Appreciate the time this morning, as you know it's a busy morning headed to Raleigh. Good luck to you this morning.
Thank you.
All right, Representative Paul Tyne. 27 after 8 o'clock. That's an interesting situation there.
It is.
It's unprecedented. And I'll tell you, and Tom Tillis is going to be on the phone with us here in just a couple. We'll ask Tom his opinion of this. But, he's had to try to hold that Republican House caucus together for the last 4 years. And sometimes you don't know how they're going to vote. And so I don't know how this will go today. I can't really see any major reasons why they wouldn't let him in.
Right.
But there's no precedent, so I don't know. We'll see how they vote. 27 after 8 o'clock. Let's take a break. When we return, the newly sworn in United States Senator Tom Tillis, his first radio interview in North Carolina since becoming your United States Senator, and we'll find out about what's happening up there in the nation's capital with Tom Tillis next.
You ask a friend to recommend a doctor when you're sick. Why not rely on a friend to recommend a personal injury attorney when you've been seriously injured?
At Hardy & Hardy, we treat our clients like family, which is why they often recommend us to their family and friends.
If you or a loved one has been involved in an accident and are searching for an attorney, visit HardyAndHardy.com to see what our clients have to say about us.
Hardy & Hardy, protecting the rights of the seriously injured.
It's the 2014 Closeout Challenge during Toyota-thon at Greenville Toyota. The challenge is on to give you our best offers of the year and save you time and money with the Greenville Toyota Advantage. Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.
What if you could make this or this with less of this and definitely less of this and without this? Let Ann show you how with this. A great taste without the guesswork. Add Ann's chicken, vegetable, ham, or beef base to a variety of dishes. Deviled eggs, potato salad, and even coleslaw are taken to a whole new level by using Ann's The One dressing. Or easily liven up your favorite meat or seafood with Ann's The One sauce. Homemade, made easy. Look for this label at your local grocer or annsdumplings.com for more ideas.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Uptown Greenville is the voice of the downtown. We exist to promote quality, cultural, residential, and economic development.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
It's alive.
Safe.
It's awesome.
A great place to work.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
Student at East Carolina University, co-founder of eaudit.com.
A sergeant with the Center City Unit.
Owner of the Varsity Club.
Our downtown has a name, and it's Uptown.
I'm good like that.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MYVIDANT to learn how you can sign up.
It's the 2014 Closeout Challenge during Toyotathon at Greenville Toyota. 2014 RAV4s, $289 a month. 2014 Highlanders, $359 a month. Both zero down. Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes. We can lower your payment.
All right, talk of the town at 8:31. We've got Senator Tillis on the phone, but very quick, a breaking bulletin because we've got a weather advisory that Mark's going to update us on very quickly. Mark, what you got there?
We just got word that a winter weather advisory had been issued for Pitt, Beaufort, Greene, Lenoir, Craven, Pamlico, Jones, Duplin, and Onslow counties until 9 a.m. It has a lot to do with the light freezing rain and drizzle, black ice being spotted in Lenoir County with several accidents. And Duplin County schools now have opted to close the schools and will not be going to school today at all, so due to dangerous road conditions. So I just wanted to bring you up.
You know, we've been saying with the we've had such dry air with these cold temperatures, we weren't going to have any problems, but you never know.
Exactly.
20% chance of precipitation, and we've had some things happening this morning. All right, 29 in front of 9 o'clock, live now from Washington, D.C., the newest sworn-in United States Senator, one of the newest United States Senators, our friend Senator Tom. We can now call you Senator Tom Tillis. Good morning, Senator Tillis. How are you?
Good morning, Henry. How are you?
I'm doing great. I'm sorry I missed your affair the other day. We got snowed out, but you guys have obviously had a very busy week. Tell us how things are going for you up there in your first week on Capitol Hill.
Well, it was kind of nice with our first week. We had 500 or 600 folks come up from North Carolina to celebrate the moment with us. And after the swearing in, we got to work. We had committee meetings. We formed up the committees, and we had a substantive bill on the floor yesterday, and we're looking to voting on cloture for the Keystone Pipeline on Monday night. So Leader McConnell and Speaker Boehner and the leadership are living up to their commitment to get Congress working again.
I want to talk about some of the legislation, but first, let me I got to get a little feel for the moment for you and where you are personally after, you know, coming from being a guy who was talked into running for city council in a small little town in Western North Carolina because you were mad about something in the Parks and Rec Department, and then all of a sudden you're Speaker of the House in North Carolina, and then I guess this has all happened in less than 10 years. You're now, boom, you're in the United States Senate. I mean, it's a pretty amazing story.
Oh, it is. It is amazing. I've walked around the building. You go through the Capitol, and I think it's really, you know, when you walk in the Senate office buildings, it could be a government office building anywhere, but when you walk into the Capitol, you realize, you know, where you are and what your responsibilities are, and it's exciting. You know, and the people up here are good people, the staff that we brought on board. Incidentally, you know, we're going to be opening an office in Greenville, and we'll have staff out there. I'm very proud of how my staff have really gotten constituent service, our field operations going. We're going to continue to be adding people, but I'm just glad to be a part of it. And we've got a lot of work to do, and hopefully a president that will recognize the American people want things done differently.
And, you know, it was such a brutal year with the expensive television and radio and all the campaigning that you had to do. And it got a little bit nasty down the stretch, but, you know.
A little bit, you think?
Try to be nice, but you know, it's got to, you know, I don't want to overemphasize it, but you've got to really feel proud of what has taken place. And I'm proud of the people of North Carolina for recognizing that, you know, we've got a guy like you that is the right guy at the right time.
Well, I tell you, Henry, I'm proud of the work that literally thousands of people did in North Carolina to make this possible. It was to try and beat an incumbent senator with a 2-to-1 disadvantage for funding only happens because of the hard work of people on the ground, a lot of the county party organizations, the volunteers, the Republican women's groups first among them. That's how we got here. And you know, what we need to do to stay here is to fulfill our promises. We're going to start, I've met with a number of the chairmen of the committees I'm under in agriculture. We're going to start next week with oversight on agriculture, on the PA situation. We'll be getting an inventory of the hospitals that still have problems and the progress that they have made since this has come to light. Being able to work on regulatory reform, it's exciting. There are just so many opportunities to fulfill our promises, and I'm going to be obsessed with that, and I'm looking forward to reporting progress on fairly short order.
Senator Tom Tillis on a busy morning in Washington, D.C. Let's talk about some of the – you mentioned the Keystone Pipeline. You jumped on that bill and co-sponsored the Keystone XL Pipeline legislation. Now, it's going to pass, obviously, and then the question early on was whether or not the president would veto it. He was hedging at first. Then midweek, his folks came out and said, oh, he'll veto it. So, you know, the question is, are there enough Democrats that are going to come back and help to override the veto? What are your thoughts?
Well, I'm not sure. I know that we should have north of 60 votes. I don't know what the exact count is. Whether or not we can get to 67 is a question. But we will still send that bill to the president's desk. I think a part of what he's calculating is, well, if he just says he's going to veto it, then we'll go, okay, we're not going to take action. He isn't going to get a pass. He's going to have to look the American people in the eyes and tell them why something that 70% of them support, he's against. And hopefully he'll begin to recognize that the American people want energy independence. They want America to be an energy superpower. It is important for economic security. It's important for our national security. And the commander-in-chief should recognize that first among us. So we've just got to continue to look for opportunities to cooperate with the Democrats and the minority caucus, send legislation to them, and hopefully get the president to recognize that the American people want to go a different direction. He said back in August all of his policies were on the ballot, every single one of them. And the American people elected historic majorities in the House and the Senate. I think that he should look at that as an indication that the policies that he put on the ballot are not policies that the average American wants to see go forward.
Mm-hmm. And the House yesterday took action. First part of discussion that would really deal with Obamacare, which would be reauthorizing people to work 40 hours and still not have to be taken into health insurance plans across the country. How do you feel about that one? I mean, that's the first part of this Obamacare thing. That has been a real problem. I know in our little company, it's a problem. You know, we've had to say to our managers here, hey, look, you cannot let our part-time people work more than 29 hours.
And well, so, it's even worse than that across the state of North Carolina. I can't tell you the number of businesses that said it was heartbreaking, but they had to tell employees that had been working there for a while that they had to go from 40 hours a week to 29 hours a week,
right,
you know, where they may have been able to make ends meet. So it's not only not giving a little bit more hour to part-time workers, but it's making previously full-time workers part-time.
Yeah.
And now they're having to work two jobs. And then you talk to businesses that say it's adding cost and complexity to them because they're having to work now with somebody who may have been able to make ends meet on 40 hours a week. Now they got to try and work out the scheduling for another business down the street so that this person who has to work two jobs now can actually make the schedules work. That's one. The medical device tax, there's a number of provisions in Obamacare that I think we're just preparing for the reality that even if we get a vote on the floor to repeal Obamacare and come up with some solutions for the things that make sense, that the president's going to veto it. So we have to go ahead and begin the work, and we would not have sufficient votes to override the veto. So we have to begin the work of how we dismantle the worst parts of it until we can eradicate the majority of it.
that's the strategy, to take the pieces that are most problematic and try to fix those as we move forward? Because, as you say, there's no way that the president is ever going to you'd never override a veto if you just put a bill on the floor that passed both chambers that says we're going to just do away with Obamacare.
Yeah, it's his signature legislation. I don't see that being likely. But I do think that we can make a lot of progress, and I do think that we should push the envelope. And like I said, if a repeal vote came to the floor, I'd certainly vote for it. I just know that it would be a symbolic gesture, but I think it's only going to be that, because I know that of various opportunities where we may get Democrats to work with us to override vetoes or approach 67 votes, I don't think that that's one of them.
I know yesterday also, Senator Tillis, that you voted to support the reauthorization of the Terrorism Risk Insurance Act. And, of course, we're looking at situation this morning in Paris, just a tragic situation this week in Paris, in France, that tells us that the world is very dangerous. And, we haven't had another major terrorist attack in this country in years. But, you know, with this kind of stuff happening in places like Paris, France, you wonder if it's just a matter of time. And, Congress has got to do, you guys have got to do everything you can to try to protect the American people.
Right. And I think one of the things you don't do if you're trying to achieve that is continue to let a steady stream of people from Guantanamo Bay go back, where about a third of them are reentering in one form or fashion in efforts designed to attack the West. We have got to be aggressive. We have got to have an aggressive strategy on ISIS. We've got to recognize that some of these things that are being characterized as workplace violence or acts of terror, and we need to deal with them in that way. We have to get very aggressive, because this situation in France is very unlike most other things. And now you hear the reports this morning that there's apparently a separate incident going on, to where they think this was well coordinated by people who were trained outside of the outside of France in that particular case. If all that proves to be true, then that means that terrorists are now coming where we live, and that's at least in Europe. And I think that's a very dangerous trend that we have to end.
Senator Tom Tillis, I know you got to go. Have you got another minute for me to ask you a couple of state questions?
Sure.
We just had Paul Tyne on. Of course, I'm sure you know the news out of North Carolina this week, biggest political news. One of our Eastern North Carolina Democratic House of Representatives members has left the Democratic Party. He's going to be voted on in Raleigh this morning as a member of the Republican caucus, which I assumed that will pass. But you, having been the guy that's had to keep that caucus together for the last 4 or 5 years, you're never quite sure what the House Republican caucus is going to do, do you?
No, you don't. I mean, that's what makes it fun. but it's like a box of chocolates. But honestly, Paul was considered a sort of center-right Democrat anyway. I think that he recognizes that many of the members of the Democratic caucus are going much further left than the citizens of North Carolina wanted to go. And he's focused on business issues, those sorts of things. So I would expect the majority of the caucus, if not unanimous, support for that. I have a number of the most unreported or underreported fact in North Carolina politics is I had a great relationship with a number of people across the aisle. Didn't mean I agreed with them on policy, but Paul was one of them, and I think that he'd be an asset for the Republican caucus. I'm going to be down there next week, by the way. I'm going to be there for swearing-in day I'm going to try and get there on Tuesday and be there on Wednesday. I'm looking forward to seeing my colleagues and seeing the transition.
Well, I was about to say to you that, it's been a tradition that you've come on our show when we've been in Raleigh, and we're going to be there Wednesday morning. So I'm going to be beating on your people to get you over there.
Good. That's great. I'd love to.
We'll be.
You're going to do it over the Planet?
We'll be over at the Daily Planet Cafe Wednesday morning. So I'll get with Daniel, your press guy, and we'll try to schedule you to come over if you got time.
And old pumpkin's right here.
Yeah, and Tim Moore, your friend, will will be elected to your position. He will succeed you as Speaker of the House. And Tim has been a good soldier for you. He was your House Rules Committee chair, and I think he'll do a good job as Speaker of the House.
I do. Tim is a good friend. You know, the Rules Chair is a tough job. I mean, it's really it's the position I have to rely on the most when we're trying to keep order and moving the chamber along. Tim's going to do a great job. He's a good friend. He's bright. He knows more about that legislature than I ever did. He was there three terms before me. I think he's going to do a great job. I think David Lewis and Nelson Dollar, all of the folks who played roles in our leadership are going to do a great job. And I think it's an indication that they want to continue to move and largely in the direction we started 4 years ago.
I know you got to go. You got other things to do, like go do that Senate thing this morning. So we're going to let you go.
I think I may even be presiding this afternoon.
Oh, really?
On how the session goes.
No kidding. Hopefully. Your first time? Would I be on C-SPAN? Yeah. Can we watch you?
Yeah, but they won't let me bring in my big gavel. The gavel here is kind of a gavelette.
Yeah, gavelette.
I told Vice President Biden the other day, I said, that's not a gavel. I got a gavel. It's about the size of a croquet mallet. But no, I guess according to the rules, we've got to use that one. I can't bring Ray into the chamber.
So what time will you be presiding? We'll all tune into C-SPAN and watch your first effort.
If we continue the session, I don't know if we will, depending upon the business this morning. I think it's 12:30.
Okay, well, good. We'll take a lunch break and watch you on C-SPAN today then. That'll be exciting.
Yeah, if we
to
end
see
up
that.
Doing it, we'll have Daniel or somebody tweet it out, so you'll know.
All right, great. Well, listen, thank you for taking the time this morning. You know how we feel about you. I say to people all the time how fortunate I feel that we are to have had you in state leadership. Sorry to lose you in Raleigh, but obviously, you know, it's great to have you in Washington, D.C. I don't know why in the world you wanted to go to Washington, D.C., but I'm glad it was you, and I'm glad you're there. So, thank you.
Well, look, I just the Agriculture Committee, the Armed Services Committee, the Veterans Affairs Committee are things that I fought for, and I'm glad that I'm on them, and I hope that everybody in North Carolina knows it's because I intend to fulfill the promises I made for the farmers and the men and women in armed services and the folks that are, you know, most important in North Carolina and the nation.
Well, say what you want to about Tom Tillis. We know you to be a person who fulfills your promises. You certainly did it in the North Carolina legislature. So thank you for all you do for us, and especially thank you for being on with us this morning. It's great talking to you.
Yeah, man. We'll see you next week.
Okay, come on by. We'll set that up. Thank you. Talk to you soon. Senator Tom Tillis. Okay. Live on Capitol Hill this morning. Great to hear his voice and excited to have him represent the state of North Carolina as one of our two North Carolina state senators, United States senators from the state of North Carolina. 13 in front of 9. Let's get a break in. McGee's got sports. Big playoff weekend. The Panthers, we got it here tomorrow. We'll tell you more about all of that. And more talk of the town for Friday morning, the 10th day. I'm sorry, 9th day. Of January, coming up here on 94.1 WNBU and 103.7 WTIB.
It's the big finish of 2014 here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 starting at $19,990 and payments as low as $249 a month here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Hey, it's Riverboat Ron on a Pepsi can.
You need a cool nickname like Riverboat Ron.
I do?
Yeah.
The Lubner Eclipse.
Yeah. Fine 59.
Oh. Kitty cat. Huh? You know, like kitty cat.
Those are terrible.
The new Pepsi 18-pack featuring limited edition Carolina Panthers collector cans. Grab one for game day. Pepsi, official soft drink of the Panthers and all for the Carolinas.
The Lubner Monster.
No. Bummer.
This isn't a park, and there is no game of fetch. These boys are here on business, and this is their office. If you have hunting dogs in Pitt County, you should know that we're working just as hard to provide for them as they are for you, as
As part of the new canine control ordinance, dogs actively involved in training, field trials, or seasonal hunting do not have to be under physical restraint when on your property or property you lawfully occupy. To learn how the law applies to your hunting dogs, just visit our website, pittcountync.gov.
You ask a friend to recommend a doctor when you're sick. Why not rely on a friend to recommend a personal injury attorney when you've been seriously injured?
At Hardy & Hardy, we treat our clients like family, which is why they often recommend us to their family and friends.
If you or a loved one has been involved in an accident and are searching for an attorney, visit HardyAndHardy.com to see what our clients have to say about us.
Hardy & Hardy, protecting the rights of the seriously injured.
Uptown Greenville is the voice of the downtown. We exist to promote quality, cultural, residential, and economic development.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
It's alive.
Safe.
It's awesome.
A great place to work.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
Student at East Carolina University.
Co-founder of eaudit.com.
Sergeant with the Center City Unit.
Owner of the Varsity Club.
Our downtown has a name, and it's Uptown.
I'm good like that.
It's the big finish of 2014 here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Drive the all-new 2015 Chrysler 200 starting at $19,990 and payments as low as $249 a month here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
All right, Friday morning talk of the town. Welcome back. It's 9 minutes in front of 8 o'clock. A lot of in front of 9 o'clock. A lot of sports coming up, including Carolina Panthers tomorrow night. That's going to be the primetime game, right?
8:15. Sure will be.
What channel is it on? Do you know?
Fox.
It's on Fox. Yep. 8:15 tomorrow. All right, here's McGee on sports.
Yeah, speaking of that game, 8:15 Panthers Seahawks tomorrow night. Pregame coverage right here. On 103.7 begins at 7 o'clock. Seattle a 10.5-point favorite in that game. Can you believe that if the Panthers win that game tomorrow, they'll play for the right to go to the Super Bowl the following weekend? Pretty amazing stuff
what
there.
What chance do you give them?
I give them a chance. But if you're asking me for a prediction, I think Seattle's going to be too
much
good,
Russell Wilson.
Too good at home. Yeah. Too good at home.
I say the Panthers will shock the football world.
Okay. All right.
That's my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Lunch bet.
I didn't say I was going to bet you. I just said making
a
prediction.
I was trying to see if you wanted to put your – okay. The other afternoon game preceding that game will be the Ravens and the Patriots tomorrow afternoon. 4:35 is the kickoff time. WITN has that coverage of that AFC playoff matchup. And the NFL yesterday failed to discipline Ray Rice properly because of a weak domestic abuse policy and an investigative system too reliant on information from law enforcement. This according to a report released on Thursday. The report is from a former FBI director hired to investigate, and he found no evidence that the league saw in advance or covered up a video of the Ravens running back knocking out his fiance in an Atlantic City casino elevator. And a lot of high school basketball action tonight in and around Pitt County. And we'll see if the North Pitt Panthers, who are on the road at Southwest Edgecombe, the Lady Panthers, who are ranked, I believe, sixth right now in the women's 2A, can move to 14-0 on the night when North Pitt travels
go
to
Coach
Southwest.
Carr.
Yep.
Now number six in the state.
That's it.
That's awesome. All right, very good. That's our sports update brought to you this hour by Suddenlink. We are celebrating the new year. Suddenlink is celebrating the new year with faster internet, if you can believe that. They were already the fastest in town, but Suddenlink is committed to bringing their customers the best value, richest content, and fastest internet speeds around. That is why they have now upgraded their speeds up to 150 megs in Greenville and New Bern. And Suddenlink's new minimum speed is 50 megs. That's 16 times faster than the telephone company, DSL. If you're not with Suddenlink and still messing around with the phone company, then you need to switch to the internet leader, Suddenlink. Give you the telephone number, 1-866-432-1184, or you can visit suddenlink.com. And, of course, here's the best offer right now for Suddenlink. If you take advantage of the Suddenlink Switch Fest, you get Suddenlink's advanced fiber-rich network powering all your high-tech gadgets, new TV, standard 50 meg internet and home phone, and they'll throw in Showtime, all of that in Showtime for $45 a month. Plus, you get Suddenlink's 30-day money back and we promise guarantee. Call Suddenlink during the Switch Fest at 1-866-432-1184. It's 866-432-1184. 1184 for Suddenlink. All right, good show this morning. Thanks to Paul Tyne, who was on with us. Also, thank you to Senator Tom Tillis. Exciting to hear Senator Tillis's voice this morning after being sworn in, and exciting to hear, Michael, that he's going to be able to be with us on Wednesday morning in Raleigh. Again, we will be live in Raleigh Wednesday morning for our Live at the Legislature. It's the first day of the General Assembly session for 2015. The new Speaker of the House, Tim Moore, will be with us. All the Eastern legislators, and Paul Tyne said he'd stop by. We're going to try to get Norm Sanderson and Brian Brown and Lewis Pate and maybe Pat McElrath, and who knows who will show up. But we'll be there live at the Legislative Building on Wednesday morning. And special thanks to our friends at the Hampton Inn and Suites in Raleigh on Glenwood Avenue, just off Glenwood Avenue. Our friends here at Greenville Prime Investments, who own that hotel, they're going to put us up at the Hampton Inn and Suites, which, by the way, if you need to stay overnight in Raleigh, I've stayed there. I think this will be my fourth time at the Hampton Inn and Suites. It's a high-rise Hampton Inn, and it's not your average Hampton Inn. It's very nice. And although all the Hamptons are nice, but this is one of the upscale, nice, high-rise Hamptons, and it's just off Glenwood Avenue where all the nice restaurants and stuff. And thanks to all of our sponsors for our Live at the Legislature, including Albemarle Bank, Potash Corp Aurora, Country Mart stores of Pitt County, including the one in Bethel where you can have the best country food that you're going to get over there at Smitty's Restaurant. I might do Smitty's for lunch today. No, I did it already. I can't do Smitty's but once a week. My wife will kill me. Time Finance Corporation, one of our sponsors, Royce Everett and the guys at Time Finance. Daryl Harrison, your local authorized Xerox sales agent. Also signing on yesterday, our friend Jeff Monsine from the Aluminum Company of North Carolina will be one of our sponsors. And Yadkin Bank. It's coming up Wednesday morning live in Raleigh at the Legislature. We will be there as the North Carolina General Assembly convenes for the 2015 session with our live show, interviewing all the legislators and setting the stage for politics in 2015. So be there with us. All right, everybody, enjoy the weekend, and we will see you back here Monday morning.
And now, homemade made easy with Ann. Spend more time with the family, not in the kitchen, with this quick recipe. Boil water. Add Ann's chicken base and butter. Add Ann's flat pastry dumplings. Add pre-cooked chicken. Add flour to thicken. Season with salt and pepper. Done. Homemade, made easy. Look for this label at your local grocer or annsdumplings.com for more ideas.
It's the 2014 Closeout Challenge during Toyota-thon at Greenville Toyota. The challenge is on. Every new Toyota available with zero down and no payments until next spring. Toyota-thon is on at Greenville Toyota. Don't miss our 2014 Closeout Challenge.
When you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco. No matter where you go in Eastern Carolina, there's sure to be an attractive and always clean Trade Wilco Hess station nearby. For the absolute lowest prices on gas, groceries, and travel necessities, stop at any of the Trade Wilco Hess stations throughout Eastern Carolina. Keep your eyes on the road, but remember to look for the green and white Hess sign. The best part? No one supports the ECU Pirates more. So when you're on the go, it's Trade Wilco.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
You ask a friend to recommend a doctor when you're sick. Why not rely on a friend to recommend a personal injury attorney when you've been seriously injured?
At Hardy & Hardy, we treat our clients like family, which is why they often recommend us to their family and friends.
If you or a loved one has been involved in an accident and are searching for an attorney, visit HardyAndHardy.com to see what our clients have to say about us.
Hardy & Hardy. Protecting the rights of the seriously injured.
Uptown Greenville is the voice of the downtown. We exist to promote quality, cultural, residential, and economic development.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown.
I am Uptown. It's alive.
Safe.
It's awesome.
A great place to work.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
We are Uptown.
Student at East Carolina University.
Co-founder of eaudit.com.
Sergeant with the Center City Unit.
Owner of the Varsity Club.
Our downtown has a name, and it's Uptown.
I'm good like that.
It's the 2014 Closeout Challenge during Toyotathon at Greenville Toyota. Get new 2014 Camrys $209 a month or new 2015 Corollas $189 a month, both with zero down. Greenville Toyota, give us 15 minutes, we can lower your payment.